Do you ever shoot time lapses or videos with your iPhone or DSLR? Well, add some cinematic motion using the ROV from Rhino. Welcome everyone, it is Andrew here from Apple Insider, and we're going to take a look at the ROV slider. This Bluetooth app connected slider works with your iPhone and either your phone or your DSLR to capture amazing shots. Whether it's slow motion, time lapse, long exposures, anything you can capture with this guy, and it adds some really awesome cinematic motion. We're going to walk through everything that is included, what it does, how it works, how you can really add some cool shots, and then we'll show you some sample footage at the end of the video. So make sure you watch all the way through to check those out. So in the box, you're going to have the basic charging cable, the ROV itself, and then if you have the Pro version, some additional accessories like a filter and the ball head for your camera. It's really cool that on the Pro version here, they included the neutral density filter. If you're not familiar, basically this kind of limits the light that can get into your camera. If you look here at the front, this is a variable ND filter. So as we rotate it, you can see the polarized films kind of canceling each other out. So you can adjust this when you're outside and control the wavelength and the amount of light that is getting into your phone. Obviously that works here on your iPhone. It's not going to work so much on your camera. You're going to have to supply your own one if you are going to be connecting it to your DSLR. What we love so much about ROV is how portable it is. Take the legs, for example. They actually completely fold up right onto the sides. The little kind of lock pops out. You adjust the leg to where you need it to be and then close it up. It folds up really nice and compact, and there's so much kind of movement there. It really helps for placement, whether you're on a rocky surface or some grass, anything where you need to really control the leveling of the system. It works really well and it's extremely stable. On the right-hand side, you can see we have those status lights, which is going to be your battery level, and then the on and off button. Simply hold it for a couple seconds, turns on and flashes blue, and it's ready to pair. In our experience, it pairs super fast. There's no fiddling with it. It is really rock solid. The default mount is going to be for iPhones. This will hold, you know, the iPhone 10, iPhone 10s, even all the way up to any of the plus-sized iPhones will fit in here with no issues. That way you can control and shoot directly on your iPhone, or with the Pro version, you can put your camera on it instead and still control it from your phone. When you launch the app and you go to connect this guy, it gives you two options. Are you going to be shooting with your DSLR, in which case you're just going to get your basic controls of the slider, or you can say you're going to shoot from your iPhone. When you're shooting from your iPhone, it actually gives you a full camera app. So you can see on the left-hand side, a little bit washed out in the light, you can choose between video, time lapse, or slow motion. On the right, you can view a bunch of different controls, including the manual camera options like ISO and white balance. Tapping on ROV settings gives you all the settings for the actual slider, and depending on what you're doing. So in this case, we're in time lapse mode, so it gives you options to control the slider itself, as well as the duration of the time lapse. If we switch to just regular video mode, we'll have different controls, just how long should the slider take, and how fast should it ramp up to max speed. There's even a really nice manual focus mode. Tap on that plus button and you get a really close-up look at your subject, and you can adjust the focus to get it exactly right. When you're actually shooting, you don't really need to worry about any of that. Simply jump into the app, make sure your subject is in frame, and tap on the go button, that record button. It immediately starts recording on your camera and it'll start moving the slider. Again, the slider speed, duration, ramp up period to the max speed and then back down. All that is controllable, including which direction you're going to be going to. So there's a lot of different configurable options to get the perfect shot. Alternatively, if you're looking for something a little bit more fancy, you could say, you can get the ROV Pro, which comes with the ball head mount and an actual spot to connect your camera to. That way the ROV can control the shutter on your DSLR. It only takes a couple seconds to go between maybe the iPhone mount and this ball head mount. The ROV ball head is really nice, it's made out of metal, pretty darn solid, and it has that quick release plate right on the top. We've attached it to our camera, makes it really easy to get the camera on and off the ROV slider. We've attached our Nikon Z7, and we're going to do a standard motion shot. We're going to start recording and move our camera from one end to the other. We launch the app, we go into Connect, and we say we're going to be using our DSLR and not our iPhone. So you can see we have the options to move it left and right up on the top. Is it going to loop? Is it going to go back and forth? How long is this shot going to take? And how quickly should it ramp up the speed? Let's take a look at a few shots of our DSLR, which is fairly hefty with that larger lens mounted on the front. But you can see we have buttery smooth video. Of course, we're going to show you all these video shots at the end so you can judge for yourself how good they came out. In this case here, we've been doing some pretty basic shots. Put our subject in the front and move the camera from the left to right or right to left, and we can change speeds. It's a little bit basic, but you can definitely get into some more advanced shots. Some of our favorites including shooting stars at night or doing time lapses. Just connect your camera with a compatible cable. Rhino has many of them for sale, and there's tons of them out there for you to pick up if you don't already have one. Then when connecting to your app, instead of choosing live motion, you choose from the drop-down a time-lapse. In time-lapse mode, you have similar options on the top, but you also have that shutter speed, clip length, and the complete duration. This handles all the math, everything you need to do. Simply hit start, and it'll move the camera into place and start taking that time-lapse. You can see it fired the shutter, took the picture, and moved the camera just a tiny bit down. And it'll continue to do that for the entire length of the time-lapse. One of the best things about ROV is how easy it is to travel with. And Rhino even makes a bag to go along with it, throw your accessories in the front, and the ROV in the back, and you're good to go. In our studio, we've got much bigger sliders and other equipment like that, but when we're out and we're shooting stuff, we need something a little bit smaller that's easier to take with us. And this thing 100% fits the build. That battery life too lasts like 24 hours depending on what you're shooting, so you can really get a lot out of this. The possibilities with ROV are kind of endless. We love the ability to just straight up use your iPhone. You don't need a camera, stick your iPhone on there, get some amazing time-lapse shots, get some long exposure shots, so many things that you can do, and it just adds this wonderful motion to your videos. Or you can connect a DSLR and get even more amazing shots. Using something like the Nikon Z7, which has that 45 megapixel sensor, you can shoot a time-lapse video that's in 8K, all adding this wonderful movement to the actual footage. There's also the aspect of cost. Compared to a lot of pro high-end video equipment, it can get up there really, really fast, and we were really impressed with the amount of things that you could do with such an affordable, compact, and portable piece of gear. All of these shots we put together really, really quick, and there's so much more you can do. If you want to be able to take awesome shots like this, you can pick one of the ROVs up, the ROV or the ROV Pro, at the link down below in the description, as well as down in the comments. So what do you guys think? Is this something that you want to be able to try out? Let us know your thoughts down below.
If you enjoyed this video, like it and hit that subscribe button. Also, check out our price guide, which makes it extremely easy to find the best deals on Apple products updated daily. Be sure to follow us on social media, and we'll see you in the next video.